Julian Marquez. Fantastic. Happy for the guy. First win since 2017. But holy smokes, Julian Marquez. You he deliver the promo. It's fun. I mean, I think you kind of got a little bit off track there at the beginning, but Rogan got him back on track. You call out Miley Cyrus, massive international pop star.
She
responds and says, just shave the MC in your chest and I'm yours. And you come back with the henna tattoo.
What a demand. Would you come and give a demand to Miley Cyrus, Julian Marquez?
One of the all-time great blunders in the history of blunders.
It was a
blunder
because now it's over. It's over.
She's not engaging. She's like, this guy's a jabron.
It's over.
I'm out of here.
She's like, well, you know, I thought about, I gave the UFC guy a tweet, gave an opportunity to make, if he would have put the MC tattoo or the shave,
yeah,
she would have responded. She would have retweeted it. She would have talked about it. But now he get a hint.
How could you be?
This is the action of a guy. Right? That's never had a girlfriend. I don't think Julian Marquez has ever had a girlfriend in his life because you don't see stuff like that. I mean, you don't. It's, you get the cool girl. You got the cool girl. You got the ball, the bell of the ball to respond. All you got to do is go and shave the MC. And the moment you take the picture, you can just shave it all off. It'll grow back in 2 days. But instead, you make a demand to Miley Cyrus. I mean,
it actually hurt my heart when I read it.
I felt bad. I crumbled. I crumbled for the poor guy. I literally just died inside of the poor guy. Like, Julian, you blew it. He's a nice guy, but he blew it.
The comments on his tweet were great. Like, everyone telling him to delete it.
Yeah,
like, I threw out the Billy Madison, you blew it. I mean, the guy just, wow.
No, they did. Everybody was saying that he blew it.
Oh, my God. Yes, totally. Got killed for it. Just absolutely killed. And didn't even correct it. Horrible. Hey, shout out to Anthony Hernandez. Holy smokes. What a win over Rodolfo Vieira. I mean, just... First of all, tremendous nickname. But second of all, to do that to Rodolfo Vieira, like, go read about that man's Brazilian jiu-jitsu resume.
Hey, Ariel, I sat at the commentary table for 3 fights afterwards going, oh, I was laughing. The stage manager got this, Miles, was like, Miles was like laughing at me, laughing quietly because I could not stop thinking about it. I was like, I think that may have been the tiredest I've ever seen a human being get in a fight. Like, Rodolfo Vieira was so tired with 2.5 minutes of a fight. I've never seen it before.
Yeah.
It was crazy. But then for Hernandez to go for the choke, like, I mean, we were all laughing like schoolgirls. And it's not that we're celebrating the downfall of Vieira, but then he got him to tap, right? Like, he got him to tap. I was talking to some jiu-jitsu guys yesterday. I said, when you guys see that, right? Rodolfo Vieira tap. Do you guys think, wow, there was a time that Hodja Gracie broke Jacare's arm. He stuck it in his gi, and he kept grappling because he didn't want to tap, right? This is one of his, I think Jacare is one of his coaches. He trains there or trains with him.
Mm-hmm.
To see a high-level grappler like that tap, does it hurt you guys a little bit? I said, don't you just go to sleep? If you're like that guy, don't you just go to sleep? They said it does suck a little bit. It hurts, but he was kind of looking for his way out, and he took it by tapping. I think for him, he would have saved face a little bit if he just went to sleep. He should have just went to sleep. You can't tap to a guy that goes on the interview and goes, yeah, I was just asking my coach for a stripe on my blue belt. You can't tap to that guy. You just can't.
If you go on his Wikipedia page and you look at his jiu-jitsu credentials, it's like gold, 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 gold,
gold. It's all gold.
It's amazing. And that was his first loss.
How did he get so tired, though? Like, wow.